Thanks for being here. Please do subscribe to the channel and like the video. This side-by-side comparison shows observations of the Southern Ring Nebula in near-infrared light at the left and mid-infrared light at right from NASA's Webb Telescope. This scene was created by a white dwarf star, the remains of a star like a sun after it shed its outer layers and stopped burning fuel through nuclear fusion. Those outer layers now form the ejected shells all along this view. In the near-infrared camera, NIRCam image, the white dwarf appears to the lower left of the bright central star, partially hidden by a diffraction spike. The same star appears, but brighter, larger, and redder in the mid-infrared instrument MIRI image. This white dwarf star is cloaked in thick layers of dust, which makes it appear larger. The brighter star in both images hasn't shed its layers. It closely orbits the dimmer white dwarf, helping to distribute what it has ejected. Over thousands of years, and before it became a dwarf, the star periodically ejected mass, the visible shells of material. As if on repeat, it contracted, heated up, and then, unable to push out more material, it pulsated. Stellar material was sent in all directions like a rotating sprinkler and provided the ingredients for this asymmetrical landscape. Today, the white dwarf is heating up the gas in the inner regions, which appear blue at the left and red at the right. Both stars are lighting up the outer regions shown in orange and blue respectively. The images look very different because NIRCam and MIRI collect different wavelengths of light. NIRCam observes near-infrared light, which is closer to the visible wavelengths our eyes detect. MIRI goes farther into the infrared, picking up mid-infrared wavelengths. The second star appears more clearly in the MIRI image because this instrument can see the gleaming dust around it. The stars and their layers of light steal more attention in the NIRCam image, while dust plays the lead in the MIRI image. Specifically, dust that is illuminated. Have a look at the circular region at the center of both images. Each contains a wobbly, asymmetrical belt of material. This is where two balls that make up the nebula meet. In this view, the nebula is at a 40-degree angle. This belt is easier to spot in the MIRI image, but is also visible in the NIRCam image. Look for the yellowish circle. The light that travels through the orange dust in the NIRCam image, which looks like spotlights, disappears at longer infrared wavelengths in the MIRI image. In near-infrared light, stars have more prominent diffraction spikes because they are so bright at these wavelengths. In mid-infrared light, diffraction spikes also appear around stars, but they are fainter and smaller. You can zoom in to spot them. Physics is the reason for the difference in the resolution of these images. NIRCam delivers high-resolution imaging because these wavelengths of light are shorter. MIRI supplies medium resolution imagery because its wavelengths are longer. The longer the wavelength, the coarser the images are. Both deliver an incredible amount of detail about every object they observe, providing never-before-seen vistas of the universe. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.